Welcome back, guys. In this video, we are going to learn about sessions in PHP. So, if you have ever heard of the term sessions, you must have heard of the term in very common scenarios. Suppose you were logged into Facebook and now you come back after a long time, the window was opened, and you see this sentence "session expired," or even while you were purchasing something on an e-commerce website like Flipkart, over there. You took a log interval, and when you came back, it says session expired, or rather IRCTC website. You get a lot of things related to sessions. So what exactly is a session? So a session is like this storage on server, where the server stores specific small bit of information about the user. Let's take an example. Suppose there are certain files on Facebook which are kind of accessible only when you are logged in. The example is your profile page, or the list of your friends, or your about me information. Okay, so these are all the pages on PHP, on Facebook, which can be accessed only when the user is logged in. Okay, now imagine the inconvenience that every time you want to view one of these pages, you have to log in. So you want to see your profile page, Facebook forces you to log in, you logged in. Now you want to see your about us information, about me information. Now again, you have to log in. For every page, you have to log in. This is very inconvenient. So what they have devised is, they have created this session thing, where what they do is, once you log in correctly, they kind of create a token for you. Now once you have the token, that particular token is shown to every other page, and now everyone knows that you are a correct user. You can understand it with a scenario like you went to a say party or fair where there are a lot of food stall. So now on the gate itself, you have to present with your identification and everything, and they issue you with a pass, and now using that pass you can go to all the stalls, and they won't ask you for identification because they know that you have already been identified. So this is what session does in PHP. Okay, so let's see that with a basic demo. So we are back in Sublime. So in this particular session video, what we will do is we'll use three files. One will be used to create a session variable. The second will be used to view that session variable, and the third would be used to delete that session variable. Okay. So let's create the files. New file, save, set session.php. Let's create the second file and save it as view session.php, and finally the third file and save it as delete session.php. Okay, so now let's go to the view session.php file, opening with this. Now what we are doing is, we are creating a temporary variable called $fname. Okay, and this will store our session variable. This is how you write the session variable. This is the name of the session variable, fname. Okay, so one more thing is there. Session $_session variables are also super global. So what do you mean by super global? So there are variables which are local, then there are variables which are global, and then there are some variables which are super global. Local variables are accessible only in the functions in which they are created. Global variables are available everywhere in the file. On similar notes, super global variables are available on the entire server, on entire computer, to all the files. And that is what we are going to see. We'll create the server, we'll create the session variable over here, but we'll be able to use it in this file also. Okay, so let's do one more thing. Let's echo $fname. What we have done is, we have saved the value of session variable into a local variable, and we are just printing out that. Okay, so let's save it, and if we'll go and type localhost php demo, and if we type view session.php, it says undefined variable session. Okay, obviously, because it doesn't know what is this $_session. Now what we are going to do is, in this particular file, we are going to create the session variable. let's create a session variable. So remember, whenever you want to create, delete, view anything related to session, you have to first start the session like this. And once you're done with that, now you can create a session variable. So name of the session variable is fname, and suppose you want to store Sachin Tendulkar in your session variable. Okay, now you save it, and now if you go back, you have to just add one more line over here. Remember, as I said, whenever you want to use session variables or delete or create them, you have to first start the session like this. This function starts the session. Now if I save, if I reload, it says Narendra Modi, okay, because the session was set. Now let's go to the third file, that is PHP, and over here what we are going to do is, first of all, since we are going to destroy the session variable, delete the session variable, first we have to start it, and now we have to call this function called session underscore destroy. What this does is, it will destroy all the session variables present on the server. Currently we have one, but there are scenarios where we have more than one session variables. Okay, so this will do what? It will destroy all of them. Okay, so this particular piece of code that is we have written over here is generally written over logout files. Okay, so now let's save it. Let's go and delete the session. Nothing happened, but now if I come back to this file, now it says undefined variable. Now let's go back to set session.php. Nothing happened, but the session is created. Now again view, and we have Sachin Tendulkar. So this is how you actually create, view and delete session variables.